Hello, I'm Marcus Boston. Quick educational video today, and we're going to talk about fetal distress and why can it be dangerous to your baby in some instances. I want to talk about this because I got this question offline, and I just want to clear up some confusion or some issues with fetal distress. Now, how I want to use fetal distress in this context is when a baby is no longer tolerating a vaginal delivery, all right? And so how this can occur is during labor and delivery, there are tools that doctors and nurses can use to be able to determine essentially your baby's well-being, how well they are tolerating a vaginal delivery. And one of those tools is the electronic fetal heart monitor. I've talked about this in past videos, but suffice it to say, the electronic fetal heart monitor, what it's doing is it's gauging and it's monitoring certain things during labor and delivery. One of those things that it is monitoring is your baby's heart rate. And so in general, your baby's heart rate is going to be around maybe about 120 to 160 beats per minute. If it's in that range, things are going pretty good. If the heart rate can get above 160 beats per minute and it's there for a considerable amount of time, then we have a condition that is present called tachycardia. Now, if tachycardia is present with other problems during labor and delivery, specifically on the electronic fetal heart monitor, that can strongly suggest that the baby may be, in that term again, fetal distress. There are other issues. If the baby's heart rate, for example, drops down to low, say 100 beats per minute or lower for a considerable amount of time, that's a condition called bradycardia. And if bradycardia is present for a considerable amount of time and there are other things that are happening during labor and delivery and there are other problems on the electronic fetal heart monitor, that can be a sign or that can suggest that the baby might be in what we call fetal distress. The electronic fetal heart monitor is also looking at other things. For example, variability. That is very important. The monitor can gauge variability. In addition to variability, it's also looking at patterns, and that could be acceleration patterns or whether the presence of late decelerations are there. It can look at these things too. So the electronic fetal heart monitor, it's really important, and it helps doctors and nurses be able to gauge that well-being. If fetal distress is going on for too long, one of the things that can cause fetal distress is problems with blood and oxygen, all right? And so that's why that fetal distress issue, it's important, and doctors have to monitor it, because if you have problems with blood and oxygen, which are showing or suggesting fetal distress, that could mean that the baby is in real serious trouble. And so the reason why oxygen and blood problems, you really want to be on the lookout for those, is because a reduced level of blood and oxygen can also lead to another medical condition called HIE, hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy, and that is what it is in this context. It's a reduced level of blood and oxygen, which can then go on to lead or cause a brain injury. So that is how fetal distress, that's why fetal distress can be problematic in certain instances, and it's very important for doctors and nurses to be paying attention and to understand what is going on during labor and delivery and to take steps to correct fetal distress if it happens during labor and delivery. There are certain things that they can do. They can turn mom, they can give mom oxygen. There's things that they can do that can help with fetal distress. But if some of these conservative measures, if they are not working, doctors and nurses, they have to be ready to move on to other things. For example, an emergency C-section if needed, because if that distress is going on, blood and oxygen problems are continuing, then like I said, you can be entering into that world of HIE. And in some cases, babies who suffer HIE, depending on the severity of the injury and what is injured, they can then sometimes go on to have to deal with CP, cerebral palsy. So the purpose of today's video is to help you understand fetal distress, why it can be problematic, and what it can lead to in some cases. If you have more questions, if you would like to speak with me because your baby was in fetal distress and maybe you have an HIE, hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy diagnosis, or a CP diagnosis, and you have questions, you would like us to do a birth injury investigation for you, there is a telephone number down below. Go ahead and pick up the phone and call me. I speak with families all the time about these conditions and things that they can do moving forward. One more thing before I leave, you gotta understand I practice law here in the state of Maryland. And if you are not in Maryland, because this video is on the internet and you reach out and contact me, please understand that if this is something that we think we can assist you with, that we have to use local counsel or co-counsel. In other words, an attorney in your state, which we will help you with to be able to move the case forward. So I just want to make sure that you understand the local counsel aspect of things. All right, that's going to be it for today's quick educational video. Again, I'm Marcus Boston, and I'm one of the childbirth injury and medical malpractice attorneys practicing law here in the state of Maryland at Boston Law Group, LLC. We will see you next time. Take care and enjoy the rest of your day.